All right, everybody. How's it going? Welcome to another episode here of Iowa State Basketball here on College Hoops 2K8. We are right at the very end of the non-conference games. We got Louisville at home. If you're tired, why are you streaming? I mean, that's just kind of how I am. We got St. John's at home, and then we're going on the road against Brigham Young and SMU. So they're just a little bit better than us in Louisville. St. John should be a little bit easier to deal with. And SMU and Brigham Young should be toss-ups, I guess, as to whether or not we win. So let's see how well we do. We are, what was it? We're number 8. We're 9-0, so we haven't lost yet. And that even includes the games where we were on the road, so we actually have managed to win all the games so far. I do like that much. Ooh, what is the? There it is. Thank you. Well, we are at home, so I guess we're in the. I'm guessing wearing. You know what? Let's try to wear the alternate. I'm guessing Louisville will be wearing red, so we'll wear yellow. It's not often we bust out the yellow jerseys.
Get ready for College Hoops on 2K Sports. The Louisville Cardinals face off again.
All right. Here we go.
The Cyclones control the opening tip, and we'll get this.
I like this. A nice, relaxing end to the week. Hopefully, I say relaxing, and then now I know that it's probably going to be very stressful to deal with. Oh, damn it!
Hempton.
Hello, hello. Ah.
Mikolauskas pulls it in.
Right, he must have thought something happened there.
To block that. You can't lose concentration even for a second. Let's check in with our sideline reporter, Tracy.
Hey, we're doing okay already.
Just before the game,
we're getting ourselves together.
He told me he's aware of the offensive reputation this opponent has, but said, as creative as they are with the ball, I think we can be just as inventive.
I think it was, what, Thursday that I
surprises in store for
I think it was
tonight.
Thursday that
right,
I last
thank you,
played.
Tracy.
So at the beginning of my
Brunson
week,
tosses it up, off the mark,
it says 5 days, so that might have even been, what, Wednesday?
Work hard to establish some chemistry, Vern, and quickly, because this is a young lineup that hasn't played with each
it's
other.
The downside to working a lot.
Here comes the double team. Cox has
at work is I don't really have the time afterwards to really do too much. I try. I've been looking at some houses, though, so I'm excited for that.
Ah.
I was looking at some of the stuff that I do on my channel and was like, you know what? I guess I could really... Because at first I was kind of trimming the fat, but now I'm like really trimming the fat. Because I'm like, well, I probably only can do a couple days a week. Might be able to do a little bit more, but might as well just give more often, you know, something that people would really want to see. Rather than just, hey, I'm going to do this thing that no one cares about. Or that I'm not passionate about.
Outright. Backs in. Dumps it to the paint. Double clutches. Collected inside.
There you
by
go.
Cox. Oh, you can't afford to spot the other team anymore.
Maybe actually start. Ooh.
They're in danger of letting this game be over before the second half.
I did get myself a new game on Friday. Gonna try to keep from making this channel a golf channel. I don't know. I've actually been enjoying the PGA Tour game. I think the new
well.
The older golf club games used to be pretty, I'd say, hardcore, sort of. And I know a lot of people really enjoyed that more than anything. But I do appreciate that they made, you know, they have assists and other things that at least make it a little bit easier, a little bit more enjoyable for people who aren't super hardcore. Feeds it to the right. Zivanovic puts it up. Can't get the jumper to fall. Near dead of 9 million. Post office and things played aims on Twitter to eventually destroy the post office and things. Sizing up his man. Having a good knowledge, they won't do that. Yeah, it's a lot of it. Like, okay, as far as packages are concerned, you know, I could see TW, but it's golf. As far as like packages are concerned, I mean, Amazon personally, now that they're getting rid of, now that they've kind of gotten rid of a lot of the mail from us and they're delivering it, I can see it, but I don't think FedEx or Amazon will ever do, and UPS doesn't even do it either, and it's something called last mile delivery. So all the rural areas and just some of the areas that it's like, oh, it's not a big city, they won't deliver there because it's not cost effective, because they are a private business and they're just trying to make a bunch of money. It's actually interesting because sometimes we actually do get quite a few. I guess, yeah, it isn't uncommon for the post office to get things with a UPS label. In fact, we get them all the time. Get a UPS shipping label on there because the postal service will actually deliver to a specific area, you know. It was ugly, but it worked. Oh, that was beautiful. What the hell is this? I just realized it's 22-1. How did we all of a sudden just light on fire? I didn't even realize we were killing him this badly. Man, Twitter really wants me to buy basketball cards. And I don't know why. I don't know if maybe it's just because there's a sale on them. Or the people that guys like follow just happen to have a thing, like have a new like deal with them or what. But most money you could be worth would get is $10 billion and it actually gets filtered back into the workers via raises or pensions. That was a much quicker shot than they might have liked, but it was a pretty open look, so it's tough to fault him. Wait, okay, the most money you could be worth or get is $10 billion. Any extra gets filtered back to the workers via raises or pensions. Huh? I don't even understand that, especially considering they talk about raises or pensions for workers, but they talk about how little money Amazon makes. On top of the fact that Jeff Bezos, the head of Amazon, is worth $180 billion. That's not what I wanted. So I don't know what stuff being filtered down, unless that's what he thinks should happen. Come on. Back him in. Back him in. Ugh.
But they're still out in front by 23. Passes to the wing. Goes to the crossover. The shot was knocked down by Garza. And they're now behind by 21.
Go, 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 go.
Mikulauskas backs him down. Caught.
I was hoping for a...
hands it off.
Hoping for a foul. Hey, it kind of worked.
Inbounds the ball.
2 points is 2 points.
They're going to double team him. Quick. 4-3. Got it. He's got five. Borchard
should be capped at 10 billion. He thinks any extra should be filtered down. Well,
bounces it inside.
Maybe, but it's not really, I don't know. It's,
we'll take a timeout.
It really depends, because his worth being at 10 billion isn't just like, that's the thing also, is that you go into the fact that it's not all cash. It's not like he has $180 billion in cash laying around. He then said, and I quote, "Even though that kind of sounds like socialism, it absolutely is. It's not quite there, but yeah, it's like, oh yeah, no, you're only allowed to make so much." And I know 10 billion is a lot, but also, like I said, filtering that down into raises and pensions when a lot of that worth is not, it's not in, you know, just liquid cash that you could just go, yep, all right, so we're going to give that to pensions, we're going to give that to raises. It's in like real estate and stocks and all sorts of other stuff like that. Not to mention the thing that a lot of people were talked about, especially with like the New York thing, and a lot of people saying that we need to, you know, tax the rich higher and blah blah blah, is they figure out how to get these like offshore accounts so that they don't have to pay this much taxes. You know, they're probably worth more than you would assume, but because they're able to throw their money into, you know, something else, into some other country, and a good chunk of their money is in Barbados, that's just what'll happen, is they'll just throw all of their money over there, and then we don't get any of it in America. Why do you need $100 billion? You don't need $100 billion. But like, if your worth is worth $100 billion, you might not have $100 billion. You might have $1 or $2 billion, and the other 98 or 99 is in the fact that he owns Amazon. You might be worth that much because Amazon is worth that much. You might have housing that is worth, you know, that comes out to. Well, he probably doesn't have that much housing. But. Dumps it to the inside. You know, it could go bankrupt, and people only go back when houses and land is cheap. I mean, I don't know if it'll go bankrupt, but I mean, they're doing a good job of. When the mayor is telling people that he'll buy them a drink if the rich people come back, because they ended up leaving in droves, and he's like, "Oh yeah, that's right, they do pay taxes."
Such great instincts. He knew exactly where the ball was going. About 3.5 minutes left in the half.
Actually, I don't think it was the mayor. I think it was the governor. I think that was the thing. Is the mayor was telling people to get out because they were like, "Yeah, we don't need you." And then the governor was telling people, "No, I'll buy you a drink." Can't remember which one is which. Got on this roll a while ago. I don't know. Cuomo seems like the kind of guy who would buy a guy a drink. Buy a rich guy a drink so he can come back to New York. Then they can talk about his nipple rings. But yeah, I can kind of see it. From downtown. He's shooting 100% from 3-point range. I don't know. They could have had some money if they allowed Amazon to go in there. You're supposed to have, like, what, some sort of headquarter thing there that was going to generate something like $5 billion in taxes. The steal by Vasquez. Ellerby, I'd love to see that. He was lurking around, then pounced. Such a thief burn. Did we get called? Okay, did we get the... All right, we did get... I think we got the points for that. I bet you it won't... Prices won't get better, though. That's why people are starting to move away from the coast. I saw a lot of people talking about that, and there was like one person that I saw on Twitter that was like coping hard, where they were just like, "All of you guys are just jealous of Californians." It's like, of what? And then like he just posted pictures of beaches, like, "Oh yeah, meanwhile." It's like, dude, there's beaches everywhere. Thanks, Tracy. It might not specifically be the Pacific Ocean, but you can go live in like one of the Carolinas and be next to the beach. Right wing. Come on. Dumps it off. All right, pick and roll. There you go. Takes it up. Hey! Iowa Rise in the premier state to move into. It's already been that. It's already been like one of the... Des Moines is already considered one of the top areas Like, if you're raising a family, usually if you're like a young professional or you're raising a family, that's where to go to. Because, yeah, it's just ridiculously cheap to live here. And we're starting to get a lot of, you know, good businesses. There's a few things to do. Not nearly as many things to do as a big city, but yeah, relatively cheap. I can make my 50-60K a year and, you know, live very comfortably that way.
The Cyclones are making some wholesale changes.
Own a home? That's a damn near impossible dream these days.
Good on number two. The Cyclones with a The intercept. What great reflexes. He pounced in and
I'm jealous of the homeless people shitting me with four needles sticking out while wildfires burn in the background. Absolutely.
Leads him with the pass.
And that's just LA. It doesn't go into San Francisco or any of the other areas. San Francisco's fucking expensive. I saw that they had a I remember they were showing a couple years ago this like house, this like shitty little house that was on this tiny little plot of land, and the thing was built maybe like 70 years ago. And it was abandoned practically, and it was just run down. And because it's in San Francisco, even though it's a tiny plot of land and it was a shitty house that was going to get destroyed anyway to make way for something else, they made something like $1.1 billion, or not $1.1 billion, but they made something like close to $1 million just on the land alone. Hey, up by 31. I didn't expect the gigantic run that we did.
Give us your opinion on the first half, Bill. If we don't see some improvement,
I wonder
soon,
if,
this could be even further out of reach. They need to make some adjustments.
I wonder if I should just call it there. We're up by nearly 30 at the half. I don't think there's much of a reason to be doing this.
We're ready to begin the second half.
Whoops, that's the wrong button. There we go. Sim it. Yep. You own a home and you're 24. Guess you live the dream. I mean, like I said, it's damn near impossible these days. If you want coast, just move to Florida. That's a good point. All right. Oh, right. I guess I should probably change the home record real quick. Well, I didn't expect that to go the way that it did. Once we settled down, we only had a slight lead. We only got a slight lead over them. But that, like, 21-point output right off the bat really helped. Maybe I should just keep with the gold. The gold jerseys might bring me the good luck. Coast of cornfields. I like the fact that it's fairly close to things. Like you can go places. You can go to bigger cities, and it's, you know, just a short drive. I say short, like within 6 hours or so.
We're here at Hilton.
Lenny Kemp, Bud Braun. What a series of names. I want a Bud Braun.
The Cyclones control.
Can we do a transfer?
Kemp. We'll get this one started. Vasquez backs in.
I like Vasquez, but Bud Braun sounds like a guy. He sounds like a pro wrestler from the 90s. Or better yet, even from the 80s, from just like Memphis. Tonight, Jerry Lawler takes on Buddy Braun.
Pulled in by Zivanovic. Clement passes it up court. Good work, Steve.
That's the wrong button.
He's not easy to stop.
That was the right one.
Like that. That
still missed.
Missed by Mikulauskas. Credit to D there. They reacted quickly enough to throw him off. Passes. Low one. Davenport. The
spin
move.
Whoops.
A superior effort to fight through the foul and put it down. Strong move.
And Dick Trickle or Dick Seaman, both racers' names.
He can't come away with a three-point play. Vasquez takes it up, slides in.
Hey, there we go.
They're up 4-2.
I mean, I always knew about Dick Trickle. Dick Seaman was someone that I always forget about.
Picked off.
What about NASCAR legend Cole Trickle?
He was lurking around that pounce. Such a thief burn. Davenport inbounds the ball.
You know what I found out the other day? Because I was looking up some things that I wanted to get. And I found out, number one, at Best Buy, they actually have the 8-bit Do controllers. 8-bit Do, 8-bit Do, I don't know which one it is. But they have the 8-bit Do controllers, the SN Pro Plus, the SN30 Pro Plus, which I really enjoy. The third-party Switch Pro controllers. And I wanted one for my PC. And they actually have them at Best Buy. Took me a while to find them because they put them amongst like the PC controllers rather than any of the other game controllers. Hey, I'll take that. But while I was there, I found out not only did my Best Buy have, not only did they have the SN 30 Pro Plus controllers in stock, but I found out next on the shelf next to them, they had Raspberry Pi 4 kits, like the official Kana kits that they sell on Amazon. They had the brand new Raspberry Pi 4, the 4 gig models, just kind of sitting there like full boxes. And it's picked up by St. John. So I didn't expect to buy one when I walked in there. But finding out that it was there, I had to get me one. Because I've been meaning to get one. I wanted to get one, but I was kind of, it was like months ago, I think, when I was trying to get it to, when I was trying to get my hands on it. And they were all pretty much sold out. Like the 4 gig models were sold out. A lot of the other little things that I wanted were sold out, like some of the cases and all that.
He misses the first. Vasquez is coming onto the floor.
So I'm happy that I guess I kind of waited a little bit.
Good on number two.
But yeah, that was like an extra $120 I didn't realize I was going to be spending.
Backs in. Let's it go.
Damn it. You have a Best Buy. That's like three theaters worth of excitement.
Feeds right wing.
You know, we're not like third world numbnuts down up here.
They got on this roll.
I mean, there are a lot of yokels, but...
Vasquez backs down.
No, I don't know if I appreciate this idea that we just are like some third world that doesn't have. It's like, oh my God, I can't believe he can actually stream on that internet of his.
Last 19-foot shot was off target. He's doubled up. Braun.
It's like, well, if I wanted data caps, I could have fiber internet, but. I chose not to. That's the only reason, too, why I don't have fiber internet, is that the one company that offers it in our area has data caps, and I hate that. And I don't like that, and fuck them. Not to mention, they've always been a pain. I haven't dealt with them in a few years now since I switched, but they've always been a pain in the ass to deal
with.
Like, customer service-wise, sales-wise, it's always been just a pain.
A second ago about that very problem. He said he wants to collapse their defense into the paint and prevent the entry pass. We'll see if it works.
Thanks, Tracy. Baseline jumper. Offensive rebound grabbed by Haynes.
Terrific rebound. That's how you get into position on the offensive glass.
Let's do first time out of the game. You know what? Shot selection is probably something we could do.
Well, let's get back to the action. Both teams are making a few lineup changes.
I guess I just won't entertain the thoughts that you
Miller
have.
Inbounds the ball. Borchardt brings it up court.
They've got their defense and it's minimum.
Damn it.
Lee fades away.
I didn't mean to fade back. Oh my God, he swished it. A fadeaway three. What in the hell?
Leads him in. Davenport. Nice move. The bucket is good. And he'll have a chance for one more.
I love the strength. He fought through
the
foul.
I was tinkering
no
around
problem.
With the Raspberry Pi a little bit. I don't know exactly what I'm going to do with it. There's a couple, you know, there's like basic computing stuff I think I can do. I can always, you know, take it to a friend's. Like when we have our card night, maybe use it for something. Maybe try to use GIMP on that because it probably might. I don't know why, but maybe for some reason GIMP works on my computer, but like a lot of times when I try to save things, it just doesn't like to work as well. Maybe I just don't know how to use GIMP. It's also a very good, very strong possibility that I just don't know how to use GIMP because I've used Photoshop so insanely much that I just don't even know how to use another program.
Skips it to the top of the key. Goes up. Couldn't get the shot, but he was fouled and gets a trip to the line.
Yeah. Okay.
Ties it up, and the next one could give them a lead. He gives them the lead.
There we go. But I did see what was kind of funny was I was very happy about the 4 gig model that I have, and then I found out just like a month or so ago that I guess they came out with the 8 gig model. I'm like, God damn it. But I guess I don't really need the 8 gig model. It'd be nice though. I'd say that's fairly future proof for a Raspberry Pi.
Gets it down low.
Hey, Tom, how's it going?
Releases. Hits the jumpers.
Damn it.
He's got two.
All right. This is actually a game this time.
Backs him down.
Oh, my goodness. Now, the one thing I hate is we do not have a strong post game this year. This year is slightly different with our post game. I'm not going to worry too much right now about the score. Because there's still a long ways to go. Well, I'm not happy about it. Because we got a 42-game win streak going on. And the last thing I want to do is have it go bye-bye. It's too many games. I don't want to start over with the streak.
Haynes feeds it to the top of the key. Carlisle catches it in the paint, takes it up, buries the top layup. And they're now out in front by five.
All right.
Iowa
All
State
right.
is really struggling. Lee dumps it off. Michalauskas takes it up.
Hey, and he got it. There you go. Oh, Lord.
Good for the 3-point play. Davenport inbounds the ball.
Grandpa wanted for Sergey to open back up his veins in his leg. Through, okay. Well, that's good. That's good to hear.
After the errant shot. Just over 4 minutes left in the half. Michalauskas backs him down. Has it right wing.
There we go. Come on. Come on. Vasquez seems to do okay. I like that.
And it's now all knotted up.
Literally use balloons or something. Oh yeah, like maybe some. I've heard of that before, where they use, you know, something to that inflates. Because it's not like they can just put air in your veins, because that'll be deadly. The defense will have to show him some respect, because he will hit that. It was just a long two, but that's all right.
St. John's will take its first timeout. Both teams are going to make some substitutions. Left wing to put an end to the run. Corralled by Eaton.
Eaton didn't get that rebound by accident. He knew right where to be. Damn it.
Carlisle raises up. Can't hit from beyond the arc. Just over 3 minutes left in the half.
Well, the D got lucky there, Vern. You can't expect many misses when you're that open.
Hey, and he got it.
The contact, hang in the air, and hit the shot. Pretty, Vern.
He completes the three-point play.
They have to get surgery on his neck because his carotid arteries are 75% blocked or something like that. Ooh.
Dishes to the wing.
Well, best of luck to him.
Rebounded by McFadden. Mm-hmm. It's a five-point game.
Hope he comes through it okay.
This run before this lead gets out of reach. I love the strength. He fought through the foul, no problem. And that'll give him the three-point chance.
Kemp didn't set the long, and he's coming back into the
I could go into my stories, but it's more... It'd be more sad than anything. That would be.
Backs on the free throw for the three-point play.
I don't feel like making it more sad now.
He's double-teamed. Haynes catches it out left. Passes left wing. Hands it off. Braun pulls the trigger. Yeah. Misses the three-pointer. Fitzwater fires it way up court.
Braun is having a hard time getting his shot to go, Vern. You just hope it doesn't wreck his confidence, but it's hard to see how it would.
Carlisle can't put an end to the scoring drought. Still a double-digit game. Has it middle. Puts it up.
Yeah, I'm not feeling super talkative today. I mean, there are a few things that went on, but man, my week was just working and sleeping. In fact, yesterday, that's why I'm actually kind of surprised that I'm here right now and I didn't fall asleep, is because I had a weird ass sleep schedule that I screwed up royally the last few days. Sometimes I'll take a nap like on Fridays and Saturdays before I, you know, hang out with some friends for games. We'll play different games. And I usually take a short nap beforehand, you know, a couple hours maybe, just so I can stay a little bit later. Rather than be a curmudgeon old man and just at like 11 or so, just be like, yeah, I'm done. No more.
Shake things up a little bit with some subs.
But I kind of screwed it up yesterday because I went to take my nap. Because I was like, yeah, I'm very tired. I need to take a nap. And so I did take a nap. And this is probably why I'm so tired right now. Because I took a nap yesterday after work. And I think I fell asleep at like 5 in the afternoon, 5 in the evening. And I don't think my body just shut down to the point where I don't think I woke up until I think it was almost 11. So it was almost 6 hours. And then, you know, I tried to force myself to sleep and got maybe like an hour and a half afterwards. You know, I tried to go to bed, get like a half decent nap in, but I couldn't fall asleep till like 4:30. And then I just hated the sound of my alarm going off. It was scary. Skipped the first time I'm going to go find a COVID asymptomatic. Had it for like 6 weeks, the second time I tried to go. I thought it was a stroke. It was more kind of a seizure. He could move, but he couldn't speak. Some of his thoughts. I didn't realize we were already done with the...
What's your take on the first half, Bill?
I can't think of too much good to say about this game. So far, maybe you can do play.
I do understand where you were going with the
And now it's time to show you our player of the half. Bill,
that's Kez.
I will just say, if you seem to care about him, and that's really good, just cherish him while he's there, man. You know, you never know. You could visit him, and then just a couple weeks later, he's gone.
Tremendous effort from our player of the half.
Yeah, we'll just keep over that.
We're all set to begin the second
half. Last two times they tried, he crashed on the table. Ooh.
Boylan inbounds it to start the second half. Spins. Braun fires. Tracy Wolfson has more on what went on at halftime. Tracy?
Thanks, Vern. During halftime, I spoke with Coach Wilson. He told me that he thinks it is going to take a different approach this half for them to hold on to this lead. Coach told me that he wasn't
That's not
to
what I meant to do.
By the book, and that he tried things that some might call counterintuitive. I guess we'll see what he means soon enough. Back to you.
Thanks, Tracy.
A little too aggressive
all right
there.
That's fine.
I like that he's
and we still have a lead,
physical,
so that's okay.
That was too much.
Knocks down the first
just a little bit closer than I'd like it to be. I'm always afraid I have like bugs or something in our apartment. I mean, we tend to have a couple that might crawl around once in a while, you know, near the bathrooms or something like that. But
corner puts it up. The long
I don't know why my feet get randomly itchy. He's shooting 50% for the and I'm game. Always paranoid. I'm just in general paranoid about that. I ended up vacuuming like last week just because it's like I kind of feel some weirdness.
Kemp.
Miracle because he's alive. He smoked like a chimney at multiple strokes or mini strokes in like 08. Jeez.
Boylan beats it to the wing.
Yeah, that was a thing that when my aunt died, I was surprised. I was surprised because we found out she had cancer and she smoked at least a pack a day. And I think she had, what, colon cancer, I think it was? So it was like, out of all the things that it was, it wasn't even the cigarettes and the smoking that really kind of did her. It probably didn't help when she actually was diagnosed with cancer, but...
Just over 10
the thing from, you know, the things
half.
from smoking
leads him with the pass.
Didn't exactly do her in.
Pulls it in.
Diabetes and heart conditions. Yeah, that's why I should probably not eat the way that I do is because we got heart conditions in our family. My grandpa died at, what was he, 72? 73? That's probably not good because from him I get like high blood pressure and cholesterol and heart disease. My other grandpa was fine, I guess, until he died. I don't know if he had anything in particular, but I mean, he still did pretty okay until last year.
Gets the second to
and he made it
well.
To what, 93, 94?
A short rest. Vasquez inbounds
there we
the
go.
Ball.
Ah. See, that's another thing, too, is I get to be worried about that because my mom right had thyroid cancer, and she beat that.
A little long, but a
so there's a lot of things there to deal with.
He's shooting 100% from deep. St. John's is really struggling. Sergeant.
And then she ended up having she narrowly avoided, I guess, having pancreatic cancer, which
has it down low.
That is like
Mikulowski
like when you have that
stolen by St. John's.
Thankfully she didn't, but when you have that basically puts like a 5-year timer on your life.
A single digit game.
If you get diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, That clock starts ticking, and it's anywhere from like 5 years at most at that point.
With the shot, It's good. Nice offensive rebound. They now lead
by
11.
The crumbs on
Kemp has the ball.
Okay. Oh, not lymph thyroid.
The Red Storm will take a timeout here. Ellerby is needed out on the floor. He didn't get much of a rest.
That's all right. The right things are going. We're gonna end up. We're gonna end up with a giant meteor or some terrible meteorology, like meteorological event, like double hurricanes or something else horrendous. The way things are going, double hurricanes. That's gonna be the. That'll be the thing.
Kicks it out to the right wing. Buried from beyond the arc.
Some sort of dystopian wasteland murder.
Top scorer for his team. Zivanovic gets it. Left wing. Backs in. Controlled by St. John's. Again, he's making big plays on defense to help his ball club.
What cagey instincts on the defensive end.
The last trade.
They're really starting to pull into this, so let's take a quick timeout and really get our heads back together. Let's get some ball control going on. Yeah, you have to watch what you eat. You may get diabetes.
Well, it looks like
they're getting set to
inbound
edge.
The ball.
I'm kind of glad that I don't have to completely watch what I eat, but I probably should just because of the cholesterol and heart problems and all that. Because I'm sure deciding to get Little Caesar's pizza, today, because I just didn't feel like doing anything and making anything, probably wasn't a good idea.
It's good, but they're still down by 8.
They're going with a little zone D here. A little 1-3-1. This should help them pressure the ball all the way to half court.
Zivanovic launches one from beyond the arc. He's got 10.
I try.
Under 7 minutes left in the second half. From deep. Boxed out. And the rebound corralled by Michalauskas.
Beautiful rebound. Boxed his man out and never let him regain position.
Leads him in. Catches it on the perimeter.
Damn it.
Backs in.
Damn it.
Away, but it's recovered by Michalauskas. Porcher skips it to the right wing. Outright.
That's not who I meant to give it to. That's who I meant to give it to.
Gets the
hey.
To go. They got on this roll a while
that
ago.
That should help.
And just haven't looked back.
Sergeant.
Michalauskas reels it in.
If they leave a shooter like him open next time, believe me.
You know what I also realized is because I had a I've had people ask me about like WWE stuff, and I realized I didn't even realize until maybe after I got done with a nap last night that I was like, oh, SummerSlam was on. Like I kind of knew about the Thunderdome thing, but I really didn't. I really didn't even know like all the matches that were going on.
Haynes inbounds the ball. Under 6 minutes left in the second half. Swing pass.
And then both
right
sides. Oh, damn.
Kemp
from
downtown. Vasquez gets the board inside.
When a shot like
I've
that
seen that people
around,
are really taking full advantage of that shoot. Thunderdome aspect,
gets
though.
Upright,
and
from 12 feet away.
I've seen, what was it? I've seen a Pikachu, a Mario, the Fire Velveteen Dream sign, a dude sleeping. Tonight had Chris Benoit. I'm waiting for the Goatsy, honestly. Maybe they're saving that for SmackDown. Someone on network television is going to try to get a Goatsy on there.
Zivanovic pulls the
and you'll know when it'll happen because they'll brag about it.
71% for the game. Kemp raises up. Tried to answer back with a three, but it's missed by Haynes. He got the look he wanted to there, Bill.
let's go there.
More of those. He can light you up in a hurry. Caught from 20 feet out. Swish.
Hey, there we're really turning on the Jets this time. Actually, yeah, that's like 26 points. We might as well just call it good. Might be able to get all the recruiting done for the week and just... Did we already get it? Did we already get the recruiting done for the week? No, we didn't. All right, cool. Who did we get committed? All right, so we got that three-star Monty Monseres committed. We don't have this dude. And he still could turn him around. That's good. Where's my targets? There's my targets. All right, go scout him. We got plenty of time to have our top brass dealing with him. It's a long shot to try to get this guy, but you never know. Damn. Yeah, I know my grandpa. I have an uncle who's a veteran for Desert Storm, I think it was. But I have a grandpa who was a veteran too. And he didn't tell me much of anything. He because I think I told the story about how he perked up. What was it last year? When I told him that I was going to be going to Japan, and he kind of perked up when I told him that. And then my dad, you know, was like, "You should ask your grandpa what he did in Japan." And he's like, "Well, not a whole lot of anything." He's like, not too much. I'm like, oh, I don't know. That just sounds awkward. Sounds like there's more to it than what he's leading on. Can't even do it with him. Oh, this dude? Yeah, I'm not going to spend my points on... Oh, he doesn't have enough activity points. We'll do the visit the recruit at home, then. Yeah, I don't think we're going to get him, but... This guy we should get. This guy's a maybe. This guy's a probably not, but we're going to keep trying. Because we got the points to do it, so might as well. All right, Brigham Young. Oh, goody. That's our first loss. We took a two-point loss to Brigham Young. How is SMU in mid-December? What the hell is SMU doing where they've only had four games and they're in mid-December? Well, at least we took a win there, but that's definitely going to affect us in the rankings. Yep, dropped to number 12. That's all right. 12-1 is still pretty good. I will say that much. Might as well invite him to campus. Try to make this happen. Yeah, we'll invite him to campus as well. All right. See if we can't make something happen out of this. He's got the campus tour. He's got the campus tour. This guy, he doesn't need the campus tour, but we might give it to him anyway. I'm going to say we're not going to give this guy the campus tour. He's just a backup in case We need to sign him. It was one of those things when I had to kind of do the math in my head. I'm like, okay, how old is he? How long ago was World War II? Uh-oh. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I don't think we're going to get him. I don't see that happening. Oh, Lord. Okay, we're going to invite him to campus at least. We're going to get that taken care of. Yeah, I guess we'll invite him to campus. We've got the points for it. Damn. I'm probably not going to get this dude. That sucks, but what are you going to do? That's who we're missing. That's who I felt like we were missing somebody. Chuisi. Reset the lineup and continue. All right. Oklahoma would be our next game. Man, I'm not even an hour in yet, technically. I wonder if we should start in on that. Oh, we should probably do some recruiting. Why not? You know what I should look for as well? Someone had mentioned it. I kind of knew, but I could technically try to get a 4-star recruit here. The only 4-star recruit. But I don't think I need a... What is a... I mean, let me see here. Oh, shit. What is he? He's a small forward. So we can get a small forward over here. The point guard is probably not going to be... You know what I'm going to do? I think what I'm going to do is I am going to grab this guy. I'm at least going to request a game tape. We're at least gonna talk to him. Get ourselves on his ourselves on his radar, because we could end up at least getting a 4-star world recruit. Make something happen. Like I said, we only got 3 scholarships, but we could be losing 2 of them. So might as well be looking at another 4-star guy. There we go. So if we lose this dude, we can maybe move over this guy. I'm going to keep going, though. Try to make something happen. And we definitely want to try to get this guy wrapped up with us. And that's the way to do it. All right. I think we're good. Like I said, we're probably going to have him and probably him not join us. So we might not even get him, honestly, just because we haven't offered him. But we at least have some backups for when our first ideas fail. You know what? Might as well do the game against Oklahoma here. It is a home game. We can at least continue on that. Get one more in before I'll be done with this. Oklahoma's not all that great. They used to be a little bit better, but like the fact that we're doing pretty A-okay. I'll go white. Why not? Love the white jerseys. We did have pretty good luck, at least in the first game with the yellow ones. Second one did okay.
Get ready for college hoops 2K8. The Oklahoma Sooners battle the Iowa State Cyclones. This is going to be a terrific matchup. Hi there, everyone. We're here at Hilton Coliseum.
You know, sometimes you just have that random point where you just have your brain just decide it's just gonna stop on you because you haven't had enough sleep in a while. I started streaming because I wanted to at least, you know, have that done and dealt with. You know, it's been a few days, and I'm like, fuck it, I'm not doing anything.
Dishes it to the left wing. Passes to the paint.
Ah, damn it. But then there's a point where it's like, oh, damn. Maybe this wasn't a great idea. Or at the very least, I'm really starting to feel the effects of a long day. Especially today, Jesus Christ. It was stressful. It was super stressful where I was just, it's about the most stressed and like pissed I've been in a while. Because it's like, we have a shitload of mail to deal with and we can't get you any help. So you have to do this, this, and this, and this. And then you have to do the work of at least two or three people because we're just understaffed today. Cool.
Has it left wing, Cox to put an end to the run.
So yeah, it was a tiring day. And then to have like the heads of that stuff, of these guys just bearing down on you because they want to make sure you're getting the numbers that they want. It's a pain in the ass. Do you get overtime? Oh yeah.
Cox dumps it off.
Yeah. Because they do talk about that, I think, on the news, where they're like, oh yeah, he was cutting hours. That was the whole thing, is they came out with an official thing. I'm probably not supposed to say, oh shit, that's not what I meant to do. I mean, I got points, so whatever.
He's got five.
But yeah, it was like supposed to not, they were supposed to not have any. They were just supposed to cut it back. But basically, it's like, okay, well, there's a lot of places, a lot of areas where they got to work you a lot because there's just not staff. And it's like, well, you got to, like, it's not going to get done if you don't hand out overtime. So, yeah, that whole, and that came down from, like, the Postmaster General, where he's like, we're eliminating overtime. No more overtime. And that lasted 2 days. It lasted 2 days, and then immediately they're like, yeah, we need you to stay. At least today was better than a couple weeks ago. I was really afraid today they were gonna make me stay later. I didn't stay today, but that's because I've been staying most of the week. Like 10 senators watch this. That'd be great. AOC quotes me in one of her tweets. I can't even make a joke about AOC watching me. No, I can't think of a senator that would actually be degenerate enough to. I can't imagine most senators know what the hell Twitch is, let alone watch Twitch streamers.
Backs down, Mikulauskas, Zivanovich from 20 feet out.
There we go. Hey, what's up,
Dino? They narrow the gap to two.
Hey, subscribe with Twitch Prime. You subscribe for 6 months. Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Passes to the right side. Fitch gets it out left. Tosses it up. Collected inside.
Oh, Lord.
With a great offensive rebound there.
Secret informant.
He worked so hard to establish position.
We've received word from our postal insider
knocks down the first one.
That, in fact, People are getting overtime, and in fact, they are becoming overworked. Yeah, especially with that, Derecho, the Inland Hurricane, because like half the evening crew called in because a lot of them couldn't get out of their driveways. So it's like, yeah, we need you to stay. How long? Well, as long as we can keep you. It's been a while since I've gotten what they call penalty pay, but penalty pay is really nice. It's just, it's usually accompanied by a fucking insane long day. Penalty pay usually only gets, you know, they usually only keep people around long enough to do penalty pay on Christmas, because it's Christmas. The Christmas season is painful. But they were handing it out like candy once COVID started, and then again a couple weeks ago when the storm kept everyone from being able to show up.
There was plenty of time on the shot clock, but he got a little over anxious. Mikolauskas backs him down.
Just do it anyway. Shoot over him.
The Oklahoma coach doesn't look happy.
Shitty schedule, wasn't able to tune in. Speaking of shitty schedules, welcome to the stream.
Well, let's get back to the action.
Speaking of shitty schedules, thanks for being here live, as well as watching this on YouTube with my shitty schedules. Remember the good old days when I was working at night, so nothing was fucking going on at 2:30 in the morning, so I could just stream 3-4 days a week without issue. It's kind of like I have to give up the regular streaming schedule I have, but on the bright side, I get to actually be amongst the normal human beings and feel like an actual adult and not some weirdo that's off in the night. Do I like my job? I don't mind my job. If I didn't like it, I'd probably leave. But yeah, I'm not like fond of it. Like I'm not sitting here like.
Just over 6 minutes left in the half.
I don't know how to. I guess I'm indifferent. It's a job. That's the best way I can describe it. Is it's a job. I don't dislike it, so it's not like I'm sitting here going, oh my god, it's just. I'm not complaining about the job just all the time in general, just, you know, when you have a stressful day. But I'm not also, it's like, if it came down to it, I'm not sitting here going, ooh boy, I get to go into my job tomorrow. I guess indifference is a good way. Like I said, I think that's the best way to describe my feelings on the job, is it's a job. It's a career. It'll keep me paid well, hopefully. Cross my fingers. You don't have a schedule? No, I don't have a schedule. Come on. Work intends on second shift. Got promoted in office job. Work 8 to 4:30. Nice. Yeah, I do 7 to 3:30. Except I still have friends who are like night owls. So, like I said, Fridays and Saturdays when I'm not streaming, I'm usually playing games. I always thought about like recording it. I don't know if they're big on. It took them until literally just like 2-3 weeks ago to find out that I actually do stream. And then I have a YouTube channel, because I think I mentioned it offhand, and they're like, you have a YouTube channel? I'm like, yeah. And he's like, oh, okay, cool. We're going to go report you. Like in the ticker? Yeah, that's been there for, it's been there for a while. But yeah, like I said, you hadn't been here in quite some time. But yeah, I've been keeping track of... I started putting a ticker down to keep track of my win-loss record at home since I've been to Iowa State. I wouldn't bet on him missing that one again. I've been doing well for myself thus far at home. He's got two. Fitch inbounds the ball. Job just pimping the post office and the logo in the corner. I mean, I'm not so enthralled with the idea that I should pimp out the post office.
Feeds it to the right side. Lee gets it right wing. That last shot.
I do have my own mom who has been doing. Who has been also in the post office for like 35 years. She does like to get on me sometimes when I'm just not doing anything. She's one of those where she's like 60 now, so she doesn't quite understand a lot of internet stuff. So it's hard to describe to her the fact that I stream. Like, I can't really describe that to her. So she's like, you just stay up and play video games all night. I mean, yes and no.
Vasquez inbounds the ball.
Uh-oh.
About 3.5 minutes left in the half.
Okay, everything says it's good. Left wing. I just like looked over and I saw a bunch of yellow text. I mean, I guess you could see it on the, I guess you could see it on the stream. I guess my chatty disconnected there. That was odd.
The big guy has spoken. Stone puts it up, misses the three-pointer.
It's not good when I look over and I see a bunch of yellow text in the corner of my eye, because that means something has fucked up.
Backs down.
He will pay me to get shit on. But yeah, like, she's always one of those that she was never fond of wrestling. She is one of those wrestling people. That's what she never calls it. It's wrestling. Also, she assumed I was going to grow out of it, which I guess, yeah, that makes sense. Sure. I feel like now I've gotten to a point where, like, for a while there, it was, I can't believe you haven't grown out of that wrestling yet. It's like, okay, whatever. But now I think I'm at a point where I've watched it and been a fan of it long enough, on top of which it's not like it's heavily affecting my work, where it's like, oh yeah, because of wrestling I'm not going to work, or I'm not doing this or that. And it's like, I'm a contributing member of society. If only it's gotten worse. No, it's just changed to what it is. You know, it used to be like, you know, WWE and stuff like that. And I'd watch whatever was kind of on TV and sometimes on the internet. Like, you know, I knew what TNA was when it was on, like, Fox Sports Net. I watched it a few times there. But yeah, mostly I watched SmackDown because it actually showed up in my local NBC station. But now it's mostly Japanese stuff. I guess you could say it's worse. Instead of spending money on, I guess I did go to that WWE Raw thing that they had for Christmas, but I certainly didn't spend a lot of money on the tickets. That was nice. I think it came out to $4 a piece with me and two friends that I got on, like, StubHub or SeatGeek. That's what it was. Pretty much the same thing. Yeah. Now it's more cooming over Japanese women. That was something my mom rolled her eyes at too when I was planning my Japan trip. She was like, "What are you gonna do?" You know, I'm like, "I'm probably going to a bunch of wrestling events." You know, she's just
gets it on the elbow.
Whatever. It's my trip.
They're up by three.
Am I playing this on PC or console? This is console. Although I might, who knows? Whenever I get done with this, if I decide to ever like reboot this, I don't know. At this point, I'm almost halfway through the max. I feel like there's a point of pride to actually try to finish this, because I'm in season 15 now. And 30 seasons is the max, and it will tell you, from what I've seen, it will actually inform you when you're in your final season. And then it'll give you like a little congratulatory message if you get through 30 seasons. Yeah, my dad is actually a lot more, he's actually a lot more, I don't think he watches it, but he's at least more understanding of the wrestling thing because he kind of got me into it. But yeah, video games and all that, like they don't really understand that much either. My dad's a little bit more understanding about it because I think he also really loves, he's, oh shit, I didn't realize it was halftime already. Derp. Probably not going to play 1080 snowboarding.
What do you think of the first half, Bill? Both
sides. Just think about playing. Because I've probably put at least 10 hours into it. Probably at least. I was thinking about playing PGA Tour. Just because it's nice and relaxing. It's a new relaxing game to play. I probably won't do like a whole series on the career mode. Because I've been playing through the career mode. There's no point to it. I don't think anyone's going to watch it, so who gives a shit?
It to start the second half.
PGA Tour 2K21, the brand new one that came out, what, 3 days ago, 4 days ago?
To the stripe.
Came out on Friday.
In, knocked loose, and it's controlled by Oklahoma. Let's check in with Tracy.
Our post game sucks.
He's satisfied with a small lead and is going to try to force the issue in the second half.
Coach, yep, that just came out.
Book, and that he'll try,
but probably won't do a whole thing about it. That's actually, I kind of mentioned it, how I was kind of like looking over the analytics of all my videos and all that. First off, I'm excited to know that I actually did appeal my YouTube removing my NBA 2K14 video. What the fuck are you doing?
Knocks it loose.
Oh, hey. But I was going through stuff like that, and my appeal went through, and I was actually able to get 2K14 back. But I was looking at stuff and going, okay, I don't stream that much anymore. I only stream maybe a couple times a week anymore. So I should really cut it down to things that people actually watch, or things that I'm excited about. And
lobs it to the wing.
I think I ended up, as much as I really enjoy Super Mega Baseball 3, I have to at least go, like, especially going on the YouTube analytics side, looking at the video stats, I'm like, okay, I really enjoy Super Mega Baseball 3, but I have to at least understand that no one fucking cares. Like, Once we dip below a certain amount of people, that it's like clearly people aren't really caring or watching as compared to some of the other things. I guess I'm just, it's just not worth putting the time out to do that. TWW MMA, NBA, and college hoops. That's pretty much what I'm down to, honestly. My two TEW series, WMMA, NBA 2K14 and college hoops. That is because I kind of looked at NFL 2K5 as well, and I was kind of losing. I think it's just football in general. I'm just kind of like, eh, about.
Passes it to the baseline.
And I was like, eh, you know, I guess I can just kind of give that up and just take it down. That takes it down to like five core things. And then, of course, occasionally, every once in a while, you know, once I get through a couple rounds of videos, it's like, hey, let me just play something goofy. Let me just do a one-shot of something I'm playing. Like, more than likely, at some point in the next, like, week or two, I might do, what is it, Windbound? Because Windbound comes out on the Switch on Friday. That actually looks really cool. I may or may not do that. But I'm excited to play it. And then, of course, PGA Tour. I want to do a little bit of that.
8 points, and he's the top scorer for his team. Stolen away.
Hey, let's get back into this. We've told you this. I know, but like once you kind of look at the hard stats of the videos, you just go, okay, this is what people want, so this is just what I'm. This is what I'll do, and then, you know, once in a while, I'll find something a little bit different, like when I did Hollywood Movie Studio or, you know, what was it, Music Wars Empire, things that just become like weird little hits for some reason, that it's like, man, I didn't realize that people were like interested in this. Just do like little short series on that, otherwise mostly just one shots of stuff I might be playing. Watch when you can to support me as a creator. I do appreciate that. I also realize that, you know, people's time is short, and sometimes they don't want to. Sometimes they don't want to watch, you know, something that they're not all that interested in. I try to at least be entertaining enough as a creator that people, you know, come to me. Just because I'm me. But I'm not that delusional to be like, no, everyone's here because I'm fucking entertaining. I'm a goddamn ray of sunshine. But then again, doing less things means I might be able to focus a little bit more on some of the other things, like once I really start getting fired up on the TEW stuff, like then I'll be able to kind of focus on doing, you know, a lot of the graphics and all that stuff that I wasn't able to do a whole lot of towards the end of Hawkeye Pro, because just the way my job kind of got in the way of a lot of that.
Knocks down the first one. Hey. Both teams are going to make some substitutions.
One shots are fun. You're a fan of WMMA and TEW series. You like the NFL 2K series as well. I kind of like the NFL 2K series as well, but I feel like I did it once and then, like, I don't know. I just wasn't feeling it the second time around. Kind of like the NCAA football thing where it's like, I think just football in general, I just haven't been. I don't know what it is. And I don't want to do Axis. I wanted to do Axis football when Axis football 2020 comes out, because I'm actually a patron of it. So I've been actually able to kind of get a firsthand look at a lot of things. And I really like what they're doing. But also, it's like, I feel like I'm probably going to get bored of that real quick, too. I feel like anytime I fire up especially when it comes to football, whenever I fire up something, I get a few weeks in and I'm just like, once in a while, I should just do chatting. That's what I try to do with like a simple game in the background. That's what I'll have to, you know what I'll have to do? Cause I'll at least put the, put like a video game in the background. Play like Minecraft. Literally, I've looked on my Nintendo Switch. My most played game on my Switch is Minecraft. I didn't even realize I have put, what was it, over 225 hours into Minecraft on the Switch alone. And that doesn't even get into the years of having the Java version on my PC. Because I was playing Minecraft when it was in like Alpha 1.4 or something like that. So God forbid how much of my life has been spent playing just one game like that. Subliss, since you found me. Well, I do appreciate that much, too. I definitely do appreciate the people who are at least still here and are entertained. Let's do defense. Audience loves the TEW series. Another different audience that loves shit like Spyro, a new series. Yeah. Finding a balance is hard. NASCAR is also another thing that I probably could. I don't know. I also got to a point with like Dirt to Daytona where I was just winning damn near everything because I had maxed out my car. So I had done the maxing out of the car. Maybe if I did like NASCAR 07, I think that's the most RPG-esque one that you can play. I want to say that's the closest to like a NASCAR RPG. Because you're doing all the different, you know, races, then you can get the different sponsors and higher tier cars, and you get your own team. Probably just be a lot to do on that, or F1. I actually do. What is it on my PS4? I want to say I have F1 like 2018. I think I picked it up for like cheap. I think I might have one on my PC as well on Steam. I don't know. You know what I could? If I could make a custom championship out of Wreckfest, I'd probably play Wreckfest. I actually, that's one of the games that we play amongst our friends on weekends. And I really like Wreckfest. And they have a lot of different like created tracks.
One for two from 3-point range. Stone, way up court. Oklahoma calls timeout.
NASCAR is a series that's hard to do without having a racing setup. That's a good point. Funny you mention that. For the because it was on sale on Amazon, I actually do have a racing wheel again. It's been years since I've had a racing wheel and pedals, so I actually do have one that works for the PC. It's actually a Nintendo Switch native Mario Kart themed racing wheel. I think it's like a hoary one. It's like a full size racing wheel, practically. It's like a real. It's a pretty decent racing wheel. I think it was like $90. 95, something like that. But yeah, it comes with the. It has the pedals and everything. That was kind of funny.
He's got 10. Under 4 minutes left in the second half.
The Oklahoma coach. Oh yeah, God. How long ago was that? Was some of the? Ooh. Should we keep up with the defense? Let's keep up with the defense. We're doing pretty good.
Both teams are going to make some substitutions.
12 points is a good. It's a good lead, especially with this much time remaining. But it's comfortable. But it's not like guaranteed.
Karacic inbounds the ball. Adegana.
You know what I should do someday is I should get my videos together, because I think I've talked about it before, but it's probably been a while. But I should mention that back when I was 17, back when me and my friends were teenagers, 16, 17, something popped up on Discord. I nearly completely clicked out of OBS. That would have sucked. Give me a moment. Give me just a moment. I have one of our friends asking about Fall Guys, so I am letting him know. So it seems like we'll be playing Fall Guys at some point too. Here we go. Could always do Fire Programming, resume Hawkeye Pro. See, that was one of the reasons why I wanted to do a new local to global, was deal with the local to global stuff, and then also at least take the risk of people maybe hopefully finding enjoyment in new characters and new things. I enjoy Fall Guys, but I don't know. I feel like I've got the sort of group of people who'd be like, oh, everyone's playing it, goddammit. How is Jack? Honestly, in the last, like, it's probably been at least a month now since I've really heard much of anything, so I don't really have much to report on, other than I assume he's still recovering in the hospital. It's been almost 3 months now, but I heard he was moving around. But then his like left side stopped moving as well. Like maybe he was starting to lose the sensation in his left side again. So I don't know. Yeah, I haven't really heard much in a while. Other than they did lift some COVID restrictions at the hospital he was at, so he was actually able to have one visitor every day, so was, I guess his mom had been going there pretty much every day.
Passes it to the top of the key.
But most want HPW. I mean, Mikulauskas. I could see that. I do understand. Him headcanon AEW found Alex Reynolds because of HPW. See, you mentioned that like I might not bring back Alex Reynolds anyway, because I don't think in the mod he's technically under any sort of he's not under any sort of exclusive contract. So I could technically grab him, I think.
Adegana inbounds the ball. The steal by Chuasi. The D was really waiting for
him. Alright, I think that's good enough. 19 points. We pulled it together in the end there. It was a little bit slow start. We were only up by, like, what, 2-3 points? Was it even 1 point? I forget how much we were up by. It wasn't by much. I got my shit together. Give me just a moment. There we go. Yeah, that was the thing I wanted to do, was at least take a risk of trying to introduce some new characters and hopefully people would be interested in. You know, I at least got to take into account the fact that not a lot of people cared really about Hawkeye Pro at first. Once you kind of start getting into it and you start having a schedule and a lot of different stories and you start building up like a history with people, then they get, there we go. I forgot to change the record. Then they get a little bit more invested in it. Let's see. Recruits. All right. Don't know why I'm wasting my time, but whatever. I just realized that the 4-star dude is actually a sophomore, so that's why I'm not able to offer anything to him. I just now realized that. He's pretty much ours. I don't think I'm gonna, well, no, because I could end up getting him, I guess, if I really wanted to. We can have him visit. I feel like I should just give up now. I feel like 80%, we're not gonna make this happen. I should realize that there are too many people and I'm too far back in the running for this. Oh my god. Okay, there we go. Okay. Let me manage the, oh shit. No. There. Well, at least that puts him where I want him to be. So where's he at? Oh right, I didn't take this didn't take it off of him. Alright, so there we go. So, I think I've officially dropped out of the race for getting him, as much as great as it would be. Let's go ahead and see if we can't persuade him. Damn. If we can't persuade him to join us. And it might not even happen. I might just end up having an extra scholarship hanging around. Might have to look at another 3-star guy just in case. In fact, I might just do that. Let me see here. Where's the all junior college? Maybe there's some junior. Maybe there's a junior college transfer that people are missing out on. Probably not, though. He's a junior college freshman. Richmond's interested, but... Oh, no, he's already... Okay, he's already there. Let's see, is there a team that's... Is there a guy... Okay, so there's not a four-star guy that anyone's missing out on over here. Probably not even a three-star guy people are missing out on. I mean, technically, I could get him. Let's at least talk to him. Nothing wrong with talking to him. Won't hurt anything. Is your ticker on the bottom just a custom text box in OBS? Technically, yeah. Like the ticker. Okay, so let me see if I can clear out what it is. So this is the ticker that I made in Photoshop. I made it, what is it, 1080? I made it the 1920 by 1080 so that it just fits right onto the screen exactly as it should. And I made that in Photoshop, and then in OBS, I ended up adding the little text pieces here. So I can add little text pieces. I lined them up and then just put them in OBS so that I can easily just finagle them. You have a guy named Doomlauskas again? I have I have some dude who's got a goofy name. I'd have to look at it. Well, that puts us ahead of him. So we have him just in case he actually does go to USC, which is very, very possible. In fact, I might change that out. But I don't think I have the... I don't really have the capability right this second to make the case, so I might wait until next week. So we got Baylor, so we'll get to the Kansas game. So we skip through the Baylor game. There, what does that say? 13-3, and we're 13-1. So they gotta be pretty good, right? Oh yeah, they're right up there with us. And we lost. I figured that happened. Our luck was running out already by the end of the non-conference games. Nonetheless, we still sit at number 7 and we face number 16 Kansas. It's been a little while, I think, since Kansas has been back up into the top 25. Texas isn't even ranked. They were like the top team too. What the hell happened? They're like amazing. Is there another team that's taking that part over, I guess? We'll see. Now I gotta look. If they're not even ranked, what do the other teams look like? Whoops, that's not what I wanted. What does Kentucky look like? 92, 92, 95, 94. Okay. Damn, Indiana, 95, 93, 94, 98. Holy shit. Georgia Tech is up there. Damn, Notre Dame's got a 97 shot. Villanova, of course, is up there. San Diego State still holding strong. I don't know how they've been in the previous years. It'd be interesting if I could see where they've been year after year. I was going to say, I was looking for guys, but then I realized I've been with Iowa State for at least for 5 years now, so... Nobody is left that I recruited at San Diego State. Damn, USC, 100 shooting, 96 offense. Holy mother of God. Dayton's way up there. The hell? Yeah, that's crazy. Some of these teams are just insane. Oh yeah, what's the European dude? What's the European dude on my team's name? Mikolauskas. Linus Mikolauskas. I also got a Bruno Borchardt. I do like that. Nick Cox. Uh-oh. Clemente's hurt. Vasquez is hurt. That's good. That's always good. Well, at least we got big guys coming. Oh, man, we have a real shortage of big guys. I mean, I kind of knew this going in. That's why I got that's why I got at least one center, I think, recruited for sure. We at least got a new center coming in next season. I'm trying to get a second one. And I keep going back to point guards because those are the people who are still around. Let me save it one more time just in case. See if I'm going to do something else after this. If I do something, it'll probably be relaxing. Maybe some golf, since I've been doing the last 20 minutes of that. Oh, I forgot. I was off on a tangent about when I was a teenager. I completely forgot. Something to also possibly do, because you were talking about the just chatting thing. Because when I was a teenager, me and my friends, we did backyard wrestling on a trampoline and filmed it and produced shows. And I still have all that shit laying around on an SD card now. I've moved it from like car, from like storage space to storage space. And now I have it on my most recent micro SD card. Easily accessible. Can you go back to streaming on Hitbox? Hitbox doesn't even exist anymore. But someday I have to like actually play through that stuff and then just commentate over what we were going for, how awful we were, how good we thought we were. It'd be interesting. Maybe get my roommate involved, because my roommate's one of the guys. He's one of the top stars. Either way, I'm going to probably move over to something else, even if it's just kind of relaxing here on stream. But if you are watching this on YouTube, that'll be the end of this. So greatly appreciate you guys being here. Thank you very much. If you're watching this on YouTube, thank you. I appreciate it, and I will hopefully see you next time.